Good morning, my dear students. Today I want to discuss about the few problems based on that is the Newton's law of motion. Before going to start that problems, I want to request to all my dear students, you become a subscriber for our physics channel. How you become a subscriber? First, you have to press the subscriber button, red button, and bell button. Press the bell button, and you become a subscriber for our physics channel. Okay, I hope all of you become subscriber for our channel, and I want to solve the problems, some other five problems. So, see here. Now, in the Newton's laws of motion. The force play a very important role, and one more, that is the momentum and kinematic equations. The kinematic equations are very important here, and force and momentum. Yes, now see here, first problem today, that is the fifth problem, according to your that is a video clip, that is the fifth problem. Yes, fifth problem, what are the given values here? Now see here, a bullet of mass 0.03 kg enters a block of wood with a velocity of 600 meter per second and penetrates to a depth of 0.2 meter. Calculate average force of a wood to penetration. Now see here, this is the wooden block. Now this is the wooden block. Now the bullet is enter here and enters and stop here to a certain depth here. This is the S depth, initial velocity. This is the final velocity. What is the initial velocity and mass? Yes, mass is 0.03 kg. Fine. And what is initial velocity? Initial velocity, that is 600 meter per second is the initial velocity, and penetrates to a depth of 0.2 meter. S is equal to 0.2 meter, and calculate the average force. And what about the final velocity? Final velocity is zero. A bullet en madutandra penetrate agutta, penetrate agi a block nolaga ulidu bidutta, a block naga ulitati, adar artha final velocity is zero. Now your final velocity is zero. What about the acceleration? That you have to find out. And what about the force? Force you have to find out here. Now, by the equation of motion, you have to take here v square minus u square is equal to 2as. You have to take kinematic equations. Now kinematic equations are very important here. V square minus u square is equal to 2as. What you have to find out? A you have to find out. A is equal to v square minus u square divided by 2as. You have to take. Yes, fine. Now this is equal to v square is 0 minus, this is 600 square divided by, this is 2 into s is 0.2 meter. How much depth is enter here? How much depth? This is 0.2 meter. Yes, A is equal to, this is minus, now 36, this is 000, you got. It means 360,000 divided by 0.4. Yes, what do you take here? Acceleration. Acceleration is equal to, what you got here? Acceleration is equal to minus, it becomes, I think, 36,000,000. You multiply 10 on numerator and denominator, it becomes 4. This A is equal to, what you got here? A you got here, that is 9,000,000. You got like this. This is A is equal to minus 9 into 10 to the power of 5 meter per second square. This is the retardation. retardation means negative acceleration. Okay, now what is the resistive force? By Newton's second law. According to Newton's second law, you got here F is equal to ma m into a. What about this is F? Resistive force. It means opposite force. Because it is retardation, it is opposite force. It is a negative, and m into a, mass into acceleration. This is F is equal to. What about the mass? 0.03 into this you have to take here, 0.03 into 9 into 10 to the power of 5. You got minus, you have to take here. F is equal to, what is your answer? This is minus 0.27 into 10 to the power of 5. Now this is F is equal to minus 2.7 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton is the answer. How much force is act on this one? That is 2.7 into 10 to the power of 4. How much you got here? F is equal to, you have to write like this, 27, you got 000 Newton is the force. Force, that is the opposite force, negative. Negative indicate that is the opposite force act on that bullet during the penetration in the that is the wooden block. Yes, this is the problems based on Newton's second law, and you have to use the kinematic equations. Yes, problem number 6 you have to take here. Solution we have, what are the given value, that you have to write first. What are the given value? First you read the problem carefully, and then what are the given data here, that you have to take here. Yes, fine. Now here, what are the given data? A constant retarding force. Retarding force means negative, minus 50 Newton. Fine. Applied to a mass 20 kg. M is what you got? 20 kg. This is the mass. Moving initially with a speed of 15 meter per second. This is 15 meter per second. How long does the body take to stop? How long means time taken? Stop that body means final velocity is zero. What you have to find out? First you have to find out A, then you have to find out T. Now yen madbekille illi kuda retardation barthe yakantandre stop agutala body stop agutta body stop agutta adra artha eno, this is the retardation, that is a negative acceleration. Fine. Now see here, by Newton's second law, first you have to apply Newton's second law. By Newton's second law, first you have to apply that one. Why? Because you know the value of mass, you know the value of force. Once you know the value of mass and force, you easily get the acceleration. Now F is equal to m into a. What you have to take here? A is equal to F upon m. Yes, A is equal to minus 50 divided by, what is the mass? Minus is 20. How much it is the mass? This is 20. What you got here? A, acceleration. You got the acceleration is minus 2.5 meter per second square. This is the retardation. Because it is negative. You know the value of V, you know the value of U, you know the value of A. Then you easily calculate the time here. By the equation of final velocity, you have to apply here. By the equation of final velocity. What is the equation of the final velocity? P is equal to U plus AT. Yes, final velocity expression you have to take. Final velocity, P is equal to U plus AT. What is final velocity? Is 0. Fine. What is initial velocity? Is 15. Fine. Plus A. You know the value of A. This is minus 2.5 into T you have to take. Yes, this is minus 2.5 T is equal to minus 15. Yes, T is equal to minus 15 divided by minus 2.5. Negative sign it is cancel, it becomes 6. What is your answer here? T is equal to 6 seconds. It means how long? How long it means how much time is taken to stop that body. You have to find out the acceleration here. In this problem, in sixth problem, first you have to find out the acceleration with the help of Newton's second law. And you calculate the acceleration, then you have to find out the time taken. Time taken, it means how long does the body to take to stop. Andre eshtu samaya eshtu time tegedukolluttade adu stop aglike. Okay, that you have to calculate here. Yes, then you come to the next problem. Yes, seventh problem. Fine. A body of mass 5 kg acted upon by a two perpendicular forces, 8 newton and 6 newton, give the magnitude and direction of the acceleration of the body. Ivagille give the magnitude and direction of the body anta kelidru ivaga. Acceleration direction yav direction igirutta, momentum direction yav direction igirutta, change in the momentum. Change in the momentum direction is always along the direction of the force. Once change in the momentum along the direction of the force, definitely acceleration is also along the direction of the force. And you have to find out the direction of the resultant force, that is the direction of the acceleration. Hege navenu madbeku calculate madbeku ivaga enada yes mass ada body mass ada idu body ada mass idu mass two perpendicular forces act agide one f1 force act agide innondu f2 force act agide perpendicular andre theta is equal to 90 degree whatever the resultant that you have to find out here now it is theta is 90 degree here perpendicular this is the alpha is the it give the direction of the force f that is the direction of the acceleration yes fine now see here what is the mass? Mass is how much? This is 5 kg. Fine. Mass is 5 kg. And F1 that is 8 Newton. And F2 is how much it is? 6 Newton. Fine. F1 8 Newton. F2 is 6 Newton. Okay. Now theta is how much? Theta is 90 degree. Fine. Theta is 90 degree. What about the resultant force? That I have to find out here. Then what you have to find out here? F you have to find out. Fine. Okay. Then you find out the alpha. F kandidibeko. Alpha kandidibeko. Magnitude and direction of the acceleration. Ask here a question. Magnitude and direction. First you have to find out F. Then you have to find out A. Acceleration. Then resultant force. Resultant force that you have to take here F is equal to under root of F1 square plus F2 square plus 2F1 into F2 cos theta. Okay. This is equal to here theta is 90 degree. Theta is 90 degree. Cos theta is equal to 0. Whole term becomes 0. Therefore, F is equal to. What you have to find out? F is equal to. Under root of F1 square. Here F1 square plus F2 square. Because this term is 0. Therefore, F is equal to. Under root of F1 square. 8 square plus 6 square. Is equal to under root of 64 plus 36. Therefore, F is equal to root of 100. This is equal to 10 Newton. F is equal to 10 Newton. By Newton's second law, F is equal to M into A. What about A? A is F upon M. A is equal to F upon M. What is F? 10 divided by. What is M? That is 5. What your answer? 2 meter per second square. What about the direction? Tan alpha is equal to F2 sin theta divided by f1 plus f2 cos theta is equal to f2 upon f1. How you got? Sin theta, sin 90 degree is 1. If you want to write down, f2 sin 90 degree divided by f1 plus f2 cos 90 degree. This term is 0 because this is 0. Tan alpha is equal to, this is f2 divided by f1 you take. This is f2. F2 is, that is 6 by 4, 3 by 4. This is equal to 0.75. Alpha is equal to tan inverse of 0.75. With the help of the trigonometric table, you have to calculate it, and also you have to find out, that is 36 degree 52 minute. This is 36 degree 52 minute is the answer. Yes. How you write the answer for this one? ನೀವು ಹೇಗೆ ಬರೀತೀರಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಇದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ? ಹೌ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್? ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ 36 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ, ಎಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ 36 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 52 ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಟು ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 8 ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಇದು ರಿಸಲ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸು ಬೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದೆ ಇದು. ಈಗ ಇನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್, ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್? ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ 36 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 52 ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಟು ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್. ಇದು ಯಾವ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಗಿದೆ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಎಟ್ ದಿ at an angle of 36 degree 52 minute to the direction of the F1 force, that is the 8 Newton. Therefore, direction of the acceleration is also at an angle of 36 degree to the 52 minute to the direction of the what is force? 8 Newton. That you have to calculate like this. This is 7th problem. What about the next problem? Now see here. What is the problem? Next problem. Yes. A rocket with a lift of mass 20,000 kg is blasted upward with an initial acceleration of 5 meter per second square. Calculate the initial thrust of the blast. ಈಗ ಇದು 8th problem. ಇದು ground. ಇದು rocket ಇನ್ನೂ ಆನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಇವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಏನಿರ್ತದೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ? ಎಮ್ ಇಂಟು ಜಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಮೇಲೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್ ಎ. ಅವಾಗೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರಲಿ? ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಮ್ ಜಿ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ವಿತ್ ಎಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಮ್ ಇಂಟು ಎ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎರಡು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾಕೆ ತಕ್ಕಂದ್ರೆ, ಈಗ ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ನಾವು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ನಿಂತರೆ ಒಂಥರ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೇವೆ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ. ಅದೇ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಮೊದಲು ಇರೋ ನಮ್ಮ ಫೋರ್ಸು ಮತ್ತು ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್, ಆ ಫೋರ್ಸು, ಎರಡು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅವಾಗ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಒತ್ತಡ ಬೀಳುತ್ತೆ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ. ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಎರಡು ಥರ ಒತ್ತಡ ಬೀಳುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಇನ್ನೂ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅದಪ್ಪ. ಓಕೆ, ವೆನ್ ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಅಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ force on ground W is equal to M into G. when it move upward with velocity, with acceleration, then force is equal to m into a resultant force plus m into a plus m into g. What is m here? What is the mass here? 20,000 kg. 20,000 kg. Yes. What is the acceleration here? That is 5 meter per second square. What is the acceleration due to gravity? You know this one, 9.8. What resultant force? Force, it means the thrust, it means that is the force. Thrust means or force. Thrust or force. Fr is equal to m into bracket a plus g. Fr is equal to m 20,000. A is 5 plus 9.8. This is 20,000 into 5 point. This is a 14.8, I think. Now this is 2 into 14.8 into 10 to the power of this is 4. What you got here? 14.8, I think 29.6. 29.6 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton force act on the ground by the rocket. ರಾಕೆಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಷ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ ಒತ್ತಡ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಒತ್ತಡ ಅಂತ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಒತ್ತಡ ಥ್ರಸ್ಟ್. ಥ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಈ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ನಾವು ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಇಂಜಿನ್ನ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಶ್ರೀಹರಿಕೋಟ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತೇವೆ ನಾವು. ಶ್ರೀಹರಿಕೋಟ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಯಾಕೆ? ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನದ, ಅಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಭೂಮಿ ಬಹಳ ಗಟ್ಟಿ ಅದ. ಅಂದರೆ ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಥ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ತಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ತಗ್ಗು ಬೀಳುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಡಿಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಡಿ, ಅದು ಸಾರಿ ಆ ಸರೌಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಡಿಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ತಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡನ್ನು ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಇಂಜಿನ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ಸ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲಾಂಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್. ಎಸ್, ನೋ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನೈನ್ತ್ ಒನ್. ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ನೈನ್ತ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಒಂಥರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಫೋರ್ಸು, ಎದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಅದೇ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಸಡನ್ ಅದು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಎದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ, ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ. ಮೊದಲಿಗಿರೋ ಫೋರ್ಸು ಮತ್ತು ಈಗ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗುವಾಗ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಫೋರ್ಸು, ಒಟ್ಟು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸು ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಎ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಸ್ 0.08 ಕೆ ಜಿ. ಎಸ್, ನೌ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್? ಎಸ್, ಫೈನ್. ವರ್ಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ತಿರುಗಿಸು ಅಂತ. ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಹಾರಿಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್, ಹೀಗೆ ಇನ್ ಎ ಹಾರಿಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್, ಹೀಗೆ. ಈ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಇದು, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೋನ್. ಇವಾಗ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಆ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಅದು ಮಾಸು? ಮಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 0.08 ಕೆ ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮಾಸ್. ಎಸ್, ಫೈನ್. ಹಾರಿಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ 0.5 ಮೀಟರ್. ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಈಸ್ 0.5 ಮೀಟರ್. ಫೈನ್. ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟಿಂಗ್ 60 RPM. 60 RPM ಎಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 60 RPM. ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಎಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್. ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಯುನಿಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಬೇಕು. ಇದು ರೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಅದ. ರೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ 60/60 RPS ಆಯಿತು. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 1 RPS. ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಆ್ಯಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ? ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 2πf. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2π × 1. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ 2π ಓನ್ಲಿ. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್? ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಆವಾಗ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ? ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಫ್ ಸಿ ಪಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಮ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಮ್ ಒಮೇಗಾ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಯು ನೋ ದೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸ್? During solving the problems, you know about the formulas and theory. Then only you have to easily solve that problem. Yes, T is equal to FCP, MV square upon R. Now this is tension. Andra, one point tilkolene. Horizontal circle andra hege tirutte. Horizontal circle andra. Horizontal circle andra at any position. Stone at any position in a circular path, at every point the same tension is act on a thread. Suppose in vertical circle, suppose this is the vertical path. In a vertical circle, at the top one of the tension is act on a thread, at the bottom one of the tension is act on. But it is different here. Now when it is move in a vertical circular path, at that time the tension on a thread is varies. But in a horizontal, in a horizontal circle, in a horizontal path, now at each and every point the force act on or tension on a string is same. It is the same here at any point, at any position. Yavade position thodre tension same irutha. That T is equal to what you take here, m is 0.08. fine, okay. Omega square is 2 pi whole square into s, fine. R is 0.5, fine. This is equal to 0.08 into 4 pi square into 0.5, fine. Now this is 0.08 into 4 into 3.142 into 3.142 into 0.5. That you have to take here. Now you multiply all these things. What you got the answer here? You multiply all this in 1.58 newton. With the help of calculator, you have to calculate it is, that is 1.58 newton. You got the answer. The tension on the string is always, it is measured in newton only. Force and tension, now you calculate, this is measured, this is in terms of, that is a newton. Yes, fine. Adakke illa problem solve madavaga baala careful agi solve madbekagutta. ಯಾಕಂತಂದರೆ ಇವಾಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಇವಾಗ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್, ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಇದೆ, ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಒಮೇಗಾ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಇದೆ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಇಯರ್? ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್. ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವರ್ಡ್ ಏನು? ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್. ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್. ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಪಿಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ಸ್ ಲಾ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್. ಅವಾಗ ಆಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಅರ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಒಮೇಗಾ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅರ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ. ನೌ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಹಾರಿಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್, ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಬಲ್. ಮತ್ತೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಾ? ಅವಾಗ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ಅಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಆಟ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಟ್ ದಿ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಕಂಡಿಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಆಟ್ ಅದರ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ರಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ಟಾಪ್ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಈಸಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ನಾವು, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಎನಿವೇರ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟೆಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ದ ರೆಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇತ್ತು ನೋಡಿರಿ. On what is the principle of launching of a that is a rocket engine. The rocket engine, launching of a rocket engine, it is based on that is a Newton's third law of motion. Yen martada exhaust gas horagade baruttala adu force act madutta edar mele engine mele avaga rocket engine mele baruttha. Equal and opposite force escape aguvaga baruttu matte. Equal and opposite force act agutte. Now both forces are equal and opposite, therefore it is based on that is the Newton's third law of motion. Launching of a rocket engine, it is mainly based on the principle of that is Newton's third law of motion. Yes, like that you have to solve the problems on Newton's laws of motion. Innond video clip nan en martta idini nimage solve martta idini yavadanna ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು. ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್, ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಚಾನಲ್. you press the subscriber button and you press the bell button and you become a subscriber for our channel. Okay, thank you for our kind you take the information. Yes, I hope all of you become subscriber for our physics channel. Thank you.